Here is now very easy to create a video wall there. Add ISO video wall. Give it a name. Okay, now the next step is to add the monitors which are installed in your network, and you can give it a name so that you know where it is. In this case, I'll say monitor 1. You must need, of course, to know the IP address of the monitor, the username and the password. Port 80, then you have the possibility to decide if you want to see all the control buttons on the screen on the monitor, which comes from the user interface of the firmware of the monitor, or if you only want to see error signals. This is normally the setting which you normally use. You can decide which size of monitor is connected, for example, to the decoder box, and then click OK. And after that, you have the monitor available. This monitor is now visible as some kind of graphic, and you can search the position where you want to add it. Next thing is you can create presets. Presets are predefined layouts. Preset 1. So we have now two presets which you can use in that monitor. The settings for that do here at that point. You can click on edit, and now you can choose a layout which is available in this list. So then you can decide which camera you want to see. This one. These are the main settings which you have to do in the management client. So save. So now I switch to the smart client. First is that you define a view. Let's do it in that one. Create a new view. And then you see here ISO video walls. This is the control panel for the ISO video wall. Drag and drop, put it there. And on the right side, I will take a camera who is looking at the monitor which I'm using, so that you can see directly the output signal which is on the monitor. So you see, you have now on the left side the control panel, how to where you can control the monitor, the preset, and so on. And on the right side, we see the outputs. For example, you want to change to preset 2, then send to device. You see it's directly changing. Change to another view. So you see it's very easy to do that. You can click here on the settings button and click on layout. Then he can change directly the type of layout. Say yes. And now send to device, and you see he changed the layout in a very fast way. You see here, if I go now back, you see it's these new layout which I change here directly in the smart client. The plugin brings another feature, events. The plugin creates two new actions, ISO video wall change preset and ISO video wall change layout full screen and set camera to monitor number, whatever. So I make now a rule which detects motion and switches the alarm camera to the monitor. In this case, which I created a rule where the event is a motion detection on the camera, which you see here on this left side. And if there's a motion, then the camera will be shown in full screen, so the alarm camera. And after some time, the rule will start or show another preset, if the alarm is over. I will shake now a little bit the camera, and you see it switches to full screen. And after some time, it goes back in the preset, which I predefined in the rule.
So the ISO plugin is fully integrated into the Milestone Rule Engine.
Yes, correct. This is that what the plugin can do in the moment.